How did you sort through all of that in order to reach a decision? The world is crashing in on them, and that's what at least a divorce feels like. How can someone feel gratitude when they feel like everything is going wrong?
I don't know, because I think you relate to this, Lauren. I think that you fall in love with someone, and even though you know that it's amazing, you almost feel like your punishment for your third marriage is
a lot of people say, oh, if that person just says anything that appears to be nice about themselves, then they must be a narcissist. But that's not how it is. I mean, we all as human beings want to feel seen, heard, and know that we matter.
If fear has one job, and fear's job is to stop you, then your job is to move.
If people told their stories more, would we understand why we are the way we are and who we are?
At the first, I couldn't move forward until I forgave. And that is the biggest part in that I actually wasn't moving forward because I thought in order to forgive, I had to stay
with them. I started practicing gratitude and I started putting out there to the world something different, like a different energy that I felt would serve.
One of the cardinal features of a healthy relationship is the ability to be vulnerable.
When people come to court for divorce, they're in different stages of the process of coming to grips with the
divorce. You don't need to stay in that because you have your own set of skills and financial well-being to be able to leave a bad situation.
Whatever, like, sets your world on fire, like, go do that.